Hello, everyone. So, let's start from the beginning to where my troubles started. We've never had a proper movie accurate Woody doll. Well, we have Toy Story Collection Woody, you might say, but his face and hands aren't accurate. Oh, I know. What about Medicom Ultimate Woody? Yes, Medicom Woody is absolutely mwah, beautiful. But, number one, he has no voice box. Number two, he's outrageously expensive. We were this close to perfection, and it was robbed from us. Luckily, Thinkway released the brand new soft and huggable Woody plush with a near-perfect likeness to Woody in the films. So what am I supposed to do with this? Behold, a silver lining. Customizing. Your figure isn't accurate enough? Just customize it. How am I supposed to do that, you might ask? Well, I'll show you in this video. Let's introduce our victims. You'll need a scalpel, seam puller, tiny zip ties, scissors, Model Master's red, white, and gold, Citadel Cadine flesh tone, and yellow paint, preferably not an apple barrel, it'll chip off with time, some jean thread, matte spray paint. Optionally, you can use these plastic gem things. You can get them at a local hobby store. I'd use them to replace the plastic gem on the holster. It's a little big, but it works. Lastly, a screwdriver. You'll want to remove the batteries first, just in case you don't want to mess it up. Now we're going to want to remove the hands. Try to feel for a block on the inside of the cuffs. Grab your seam puller and unstitch the thread that holds the cloth together. Once that's done, cut the zip tie with your scalpel and remove the hand. Ah! Now on to Disney Store Woody. You want to uncover the cuffs and you'll find the zip tie right under there. Just cut it and you'll be able to pull it off easily. Comparing the Disney Store hands to the collection one, and you'll notice the collection peg thing is smaller than the Disney Store one. You probably could sand it down so it could like fit better, but it'll probably be better not to because it feels very hollow and it might mess it up. If you'd like to, you can repaint the hands to match the skin tone of the head by mixing some Citadel Cadine flesh tone with a little red and white. Then you want to bring in your matte spray paint and give it a few coats about 12 inches away. Then you can put in a new zip tie to tie it on and tighten it up. So now we get to the part where I explain why this is called a kinda tutorial. You see, the Woody I have on the screen right now was originally owned by someone else, and they sort of broke it, and got it fixed with a screw. So all I can tell you is, watch someone else's video on how to remove the head. But lo and behold, after carefully using boiled water to heat up, which, by the way, use a hairdryer, it's much more safer and less risky to damage your doll. I finally removed the head. To get the voice box out, just do the same thing you did with the hand. Look for the block, use the seam puller, and cut the zip tie off. Cut the seam connecting to the bandana to the shirt as well. untie the ring, and do not let go of the string, or else it will go all the way inside the box. To keep that from happening, I tied it on a zip tie and closed it up so it won't go in there. Unfortunately, I don't have any pictures of that, so I can't really show you. I'm sorry. I took the vest off by using a seam puller. The reason why is because I wanted to clean the body. Preferably, you want to do this by hand using some blue Dawn soap, but I'm lazy and impatient, so I just threw it in my washer and used the Dawn soap there. After that, cook yourself a nice steak dinner. You've earned it for all your hard work so far.
Now on to Plush Woody.
Again, use the seam puller and cut off the zip tie. If you're planning to use the Disney Store voice box, you don't have to cut off the soft and huggable head's neck joint thing, but if you decide to keep the original voice box, then you'll have to cut it off, which is what I did. I heated up the original head by using boiling water, again, use a hair dryer. I pulled the peg out and attached it to the new head. Can we just appreciate for a second on how much better the new head is compared to the old one? The old one is pretty ugly. Then again, I've seen worse. After that, I replaced the knee thread with new thread, cause mine was all messed up. There's a video on how to sew in the link in the description down below. I'm too lazy to speak cause I'm editing this at like 3 something in the morning. Oh my gosh. By the way, if you're like a little kid, definitely get one of your parents to help you with this part. You know, I'm not responsible for whatever happens to you. So yeah.
good as new. By the way, did you know this cheap Woody hat from Toy Story 3 is magnetic? Thought I'd let you all know that, because why not? After sewing the vest on, which I have no footage of, great, screwing the head back on, repainting the gold to a flat gold, and putting the new hands on, he's finally finished. And that's my horribly put together video on how to get a movie accurate Woody. Please let me know what you think about it. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.
And please subscribe for more content like this in the future. If you didn't like this video, then by all means, give it a dislike. Okay, that's it. Bye.